Welcome to DIY Solar and Wind. If you want to make your own free electricity, if you want to make your own solar heat and many other solar items, click on the links down below. Today I'm at the Air Museum. I've been losing a lot of subscribers. I might be starting up another channel real quick, like, so I can do all of my adventures for these airplanes, okay? At the Air Zoo, Kalamazoo Air Zoo, and the Gilmore Car Museum. So, go to zoos and many other places. I'm going to be traveling this year. I'm going to do a lot more things than I've ever done in 1 year. That's what I'm going to do. But I'll keep the DIY Solar and Wind. I'm going to separate it here pretty soon from all of the many, many adventures that I'm going on. Today, I'm here at the Air Museum, Kalamazoo. This airplane is a Fairchild PT-23 Cornell. Fits two people. It's got a lot of little engines on there. I find all of this very, very fascinating. I'm going to read the description. Fairchild PT-23 Cornell was initially designed to provide a monoplane trainer that would use an inline Ranger engine, also produced by Fairchild. The first Cornell model produced was PT-19. When the U.S. entered World War II, there was a great demand for more trainers, more than Fairchild could produce, so other companies built the Cornell. Air Zoo's plane was built by Howard. When a shortage of Ranger engines threatened production, the PT-23 model was introduced with a Continental W670 radio power plant. We getting the airplane in here? Compared to the easier biplane trainers, the Fairchild Cornell provided a more advanced type of aircraft. Speeds were higher and wing loading more closely approximated that the combat aircraft with flight characteristics demanding more precision and care. The Cornell was inexpensive and simple to maintain and virtually priceless. First flight, May 15, 1939, was a PT-19. Entered service September 22, 1939, wingspan 35 foot. Pretty interesting. I don't even know if I was even aiming at the plane. But you got to hear the story. Welcome to the Kalamazoo Air Museum, and have a nice sunny day.